My friends Parker and Whitney from Stock and Barrel came up to the shop this week, and we toured around the shop and showed them everything, went through all the equipment, and we also filmed the making of our camera harness. And I noticed on their YouTube channel that they had a video that was 10 basic tools that every beginner leather worker needs. And it's an awesome resource for anyone who's wanting to get into leatherworking. And they're all really, really nice tools that you can buy from Tandy and all these specialty shops. But when I started leatherworking, I was super poor and I couldn't afford all the really nice tools. And so I just kind of scrounged different tools from stuff I already owned and went to Harbor Freight and bought whatever I could. So I thought I would put together a little list of tools that you can buy right now from Harbor Freight. And the thing is, when you start leatherworking, you're gonna suck anyway. And so you don't need those super fancy tools until you kind of have the trade down anyway. So these tools are really good to just start out with, spend a little bit of money, make sure you're actually into the leather crafting world and that you enjoy it. And then once you kind of invest a little more time and you know that you wanna do it, you can invest in some better equipment like the ones that are on Stock and Barrel's video, which I'll link in the description so you guys can check that out. So let's go through each of these 9 tools and we'll talk about the price and the use of the tool and the more costly alternative and why you might wanna upgrade or why you might wanna stick with the cheap Harbor Freight version. So the first tool on my list, in no particular order, this just happens to be the way that the cashier rung them up, is the leather punch tool. This guy is $6.99 and this is a perfect tool for punching holes for stitching, punching holes for rivets, for buttons. You'll be surprised how many times you use this tool. The smallest hole on this punch is a little too big for stitching, but if you don't have any other way of doing it, this is a quick and easy way to do it. The next tool is our stainless steel ruler. This is a vital tool if you want your leatherworking to look nice, because if you're just freehanding a straight line with a razor, no matter how good you are, it's gonna be a little bit wavy here and there. But for $1.99, you can get a steel ruler that's gonna make sure that every single one of your cuts is perfectly straight. Cause all you have to do is line up your blade right next to the edge of the ruler and just guide it along and you always get a straight line. Next is the 4-inch scratch awl. This is a good tool for when you are trying to trace a pattern into a piece of leather. So say you've printed off your pattern, you've drawn out your pattern. Now you need to transfer that pattern onto the leather. This is a perfect tool for that because you can go on top of that pattern or you can cut the pattern out and run alongside of it, and it's gonna put a little teeny scratch into your leather so that when you come back in with your knife and your ruler, you can follow that line and make sure that you're not going off your pattern. You can also use this for when you're punching stitching holes. You can use the point of this and a hammer and create smaller stitching holes. Ultimately, the best tool for that would be one of these tools. This is just a pricking iron or a stitching hole punch. They don't have any of these at Harbor Freight, but they do have them on Amazon for really cheap. I think they're like $10 or $15 for a set of 3, but I'll add a link to a few of them in the description. Next up is the quick stitch sewing awl. I don't really use these, but for $6.50, you get a nice big spool of thread to use. You know, this is a lot thicker than sewing machine thread. Like that was like the hardest thing for me, is like when I first started doing leather working, I couldn't find thick thread. All I could find was like the sewing machine thread. And then everyone's like,
use floss, it'll look cool.
And then it looked terrible. So this is a good way to get some thread. And it's also a good way to, if you can learn how to use this, it's a little bit tricky. I don't have a tutorial on it, but there's plenty of them on YouTube. Next is the 13-piece precision knife set. This isn't a necessity. I chose this 13-piece knife set because it's only $4 and you have like multiple blades in there that go from flat blades where you can just press it straight into the leather and it's gonna create a clean line for buttons, you know, like those little brass buttons that pop through. It's got hooked blades and like curved blades and just like regular razor blades. It's a really good way to learn which type of knife works best for your style of cutting. So, because like for me, like I don't usually use these. I use the majority of the time, I just use like a typical utility knife. Like I've had my knife for like 6 years and I found it in a couch in my apartment at Snow College and I use it pretty much every day since. Another option is 50-cent blades. And they were out of these at Harbor Freight, but I just happened to have one at the shop. They're the type of blades that have the blade that breaks off. Once your blade's a little bit dull, you can just break off one end and you've got a brand new sharp blade. And they're 50 cents, so if you're only doing like one or two projects, this is hard to beat. If you're trying to learn a few different techniques and use a more versatile knife, this is a good option. And then these are like $5 or $6 at Harbor Freight, I think. Next up is the hole punch set. It's a 9-piece set. These will come in handy if you need to have a hole punched in the middle of the hide, because the problem with this style of punch is you're not gonna be able to reach all the way into the middle of the hide. You can only reach as far as this jaw is open. So if you're gonna do a lot of like interior punches, this is a good set. If you're gonna do mostly on the edge, this is a good set. But you know, this set is only $9. So between the two, you're spending like $16, $17 for like as many holes as you could possibly punch. It's a good set to have. Buying both's not a bad idea. Next up is your technical measuring set. This is a 6-piece set, but really the only tool that I would really use that often in this is the, I don't even know what it's called, but it's this one right here. This is a useful tool for spacing out your stitching punches, because if you're using this and you're just eyeballing the gap between each hole, you're gonna have a funny looking stitch. But if you can use this to spin and mark each hole as you go, then you know for sure that every single one of your stitching holes is equally spaced apart. You can also use this for marking the edge of your leather to make sure that your stitch is equal all the way around. The other tools, not as useful, but the whole set's only $10. And you know, for $10, maybe you can find other ways to use these tools, but for sure it's worth just this one tool alone. Next is something, you know, this isn't quite maybe as needed as the other tools. It's just a cutting board. These cutting boards are $9. When I started, I didn't go buy a cutting board. I just went and stole my mom's old cutting board, and we still use it every day in the shop on the Arbor Press. And it's lasted like 5 years and hundreds and maybe even thousands of punches. Just make sure it's not a glass or a wood one. You can still use wood, and maybe if you don't want to buy a cutting board set, maybe use a piece of wood. But these cutting boards are gonna save the edge of your blades longer, and they're gonna preserve your punches. So if you can go out and buy a cutting board, or go to a local thrift store and buy one, or steal your mom's, whatever, it's a really handy tool. Next up is the nylon head teardrop mallet. I've had one of these for like basically since I started. I've used this every single day, whether it's on the clicker press, setting dies. The nice thing about this style of hammer over like a regular steel hammer is it's not gonna break your wooden handles as much if you're hammering on this awl, and it's not gonna start mushrooming out your punches and your other metal things that you're hammering on. These also have a lifetime warranty, so you know, if your hammer ends up looking like mine in 5 years and the head starts to get a little bit loose, you can just take this into Harbor Freight and they'll give you a brand new one. And these are $9, so not the cheapest hammer at Harbor Freight, but this is the one I've always used. And it's really similar to just a regular leather working hammer. Like, I think they're both nylon heads. This style might have a little bit softer nylon, and it weighs a little bit more. They have weights in the end so that you don't have to hammer as hard. You let the hammer do, the weight of the hammer do the work. This one's lighter, but you know, these things, like a really nice one's like $100. And these are $9, so you know, it's hard to beat these. And that's everything that I found at Harbor Freight. This is a really good set to start you off on leather working. You know, the only things that you might need to buy elsewhere is like this stitching punch that I was talking about earlier, and maybe some sort of burnishing tool. Both of these are really cheap on Amazon, and so I'll include those in the description, and any other tools that I can think of that are really good beginner tools that you might be interested in buying. But these are really good basic tools to just test it out, see if you like it, and you know, get your start without spending a fortune. If this was useful to you, do me a favor and like and subscribe and comment and whatever else. The reason that we have to ask for that is because that's how we grow the channel, and that's how YouTube's algorithm prioritizes videos. So do me a huge favor and do that. I hate asking for it, but it helps a lot. Thanks.
I still think my face was in the light too much, but we'll make it work.